This presentation we will see the solar panel and anti-solar panel comparison in terms of characteristics curve. This is the overview of the presentation where we have two sections. For the first section is related to solar panel and the second section is related to anti-solar panel. So we will see the behavior of each channels one by one.
1883, Charles Fritsch has created the selenium solar cell, but this is not much impact on the public since it has a huge amount involved, and also there is no mathematical equations governing to the selenium solar cell, so this is a failure case. Now in the year 1900, the quantum mechanics was introduced by Planck. This he gave us the window to formulate the equation. That equations are related with the photovoltaic cell. That was a huge revolution happened in the photovoltaic effect. In 1905, Einstein published the paper on photovoltaic effect. He governed the equation. He explained the photovoltaic effect with the help of photons. So that is a beginning step of photovoltaic effect in 1905. In 1933, Grönthal published a copper cuprous oxide solar cell, which is having low cost production. And within the 2 years gap, he published more paper about 38 publications in that area, copper cuprous cell. In 1941, the first solar cell was invented by Russell Cole, which is made up of silicon material, which will produce efficiency of 1%. But it is not placed that much commercial value since the efficiency is very, very less, 1%, not even 1%, it is less than 1%. It has no effect on the public. In 1954, the solar cell, the efficiency is somewhat improved by 6%. Modeled by Chaplin, Fuller, and Pearson, that we have the efficiency is 6%. In 1958, the solar panel was powered with solar space exploration. This is the first spacecraft whose name is Vancraft. Vancraft having six solar panel mounted on it, which is having the wattage rate of 5 milliwatt. So which this solar cell was reported that it was working about 6 years, and during the 6 years it has performed well, it was reported. And in 1979, the installed solar panel, from 1979 onwards, the solar panel is installed in the household applications. From the inception of a solar panel photovoltaic effect, 180 years gone till now, but still research is going on, but to improve the efficiency of the solar panel. Now the efficiency is nearly about 16 to 20% based on the material we selected, but still research is going on to improve the efficiency of the solar panel. Now, these are the five largest solar plant in the world, in which our India having the three plants. One is Karnataka, Andhra Pradesh, and another one is in our Tamil Nadu, having the 648. This it is located at Kamudi, 648 megawatt. It is present at only a single place having 10 km² area, right, which is under construction now. Next, we will see the photovoltaic. What is photovoltaic effect? How the photovoltaic effect happened in the PN junction? With the help of PN junction, we will see. Then, how the voltage is generated, voltage and power is generated from the PV cell, that we will see. Right. Now, here, this is a basic PN junction diode having N-type semiconductor and a P-type semiconductor. In between, we have the depletion layer. In the depletion layer, we have the electric field. This electric field is the driving force to generate the power. This is electric field. We have the plus symbol and a minus symbol. This electric field is the driving force for the electric power generation on the PV panel. So again, see this sunlight. When the sunlight is incident on the PV panel, there is a electron hole pair is generated in the depletion layer. That electrons and holes moves towards the edge of the panel. There is a potential difference happened in say among the edge of the solar panel, that is the PV junction, that potential difference when we connect any load is, here we have connected the bulb as a load through which the electrons are flowing, thereby the current is flowing. So this process is happen as long as the sunlight is present. This process is continuously happen as long as right. So this process is happen as long as the sunlight is available. Now this this photovoltaic effect is happen in the PN junction. This PN junction is nothing but a diode. So we will see. We will explain the characteristics. Characteristics of PV junction.
So if your result will feed the knowledge. So if the leaves is like black color, so that's not
right. Right. So here this PV photovoltaic junction is nothing but a diode. So this we will explain the characteristics of photovoltaic diode. Photovoltaic cell with the help of a diode. So this is a well-known characteristic equation of the diode, having the forward graph and a reverse graph. So we will concentrate only the forward graph. So this is a forward characteristics of the PV cell. So when this curve is pulled down, by an amount, so the behind which there is a lot of technical experts are there, but for time being we will assume that when we pull down this curve towards down, so this is a arrangement like this. This is an arrangement like this. Again, when we flip the curve by 180 degree, that is this horizon, this curved area. Curved area is nothing but the working area. That working area we modeled like this. This curved line. This working area is nothing modeled as like this. And this vertical line is nothing but this line. Horizontal line. Now here in this horizontal line is nothing but this line, right? So this is a basic IV characteristics of a photovoltaic cell, having current in the y-axis and voltage in the x-axis, so which will have the slope like this, which will have the curve like this. Now here, this is a model of a photovoltaic cell with one diode and one current source. This current source is nothing but a sunlight, that is IP is nothing but a photon current that we will take. So we will not concentrate much on this. Now we will see only the characteristics, how the characteristics are arrived from the diode characteristics. This is a basic principle. Now when this is all up, this is a graph with a different insulation level, that is a different irradiance level of a solar cell. So this is straight line, as we have seen it previously. This is IV curve having straight line, then having a curve, then again it is going down. So this is a curve, that is in this y-axis having current and x-axis having voltage. So this curve is drawn for different insulation levels, starting from 2200 watts per meter square to 1000 watts per meter square under standard test condition at a standard room temperature. So as the insulation varies, the current also continuously varies. And of course, we have another graph called a PV curve, where power is plotted in y-axis, voltage plotted in x-axis. Again, this power is generated from the PV panel is keep on increasing when the insulation level is increasing from 200 to 1000. So always we need to operate this PV panel at the peak power. That is, this is a peak power, and for this graph, this is a peak power, and this graph, this is a peak power. And so always we need to operate the PV panel under the peak point. So that peak point we called as maximum power point. So we need to always track that power point. So power point, that technique is called a maximum power point techniques. So keep in mind, always we need to operate the solar panel in maximum power point. We need to track the maximum point. For that, a different power point tracking methods are there, in which the first one is conventional methods. Conventional method having different types, there is number of conventional methods are there. The conventional method, essentially we are taking voltage and current factor as a reference, using some manipulation, mathematical manipulation. We will do some calculation and track the power. That is, based on the method, the calculation is different. So all the methods having its own advantage and disadvantage. So that we will see later. That we will see in some review papers. There are many of the research papers are available in research paper, and review papers are there in maximum PowerPoint tracking. So this is about conventional method. And also we have the soft computing methods. There are numerous soft computing methods are there, which will effectively use to reduce the tracking time. But this is some of the methods we have shown, and this is also some of the methods to track the maximum power point. Still, the research is going on to improve. This list is going on to track the maximum power point tracking. Now we have introduced one more law corresponding to PN junction called mass action law. This mass action law is the product of pore concentration and the electron concentration under the thermal equilibrium is equal to the square of intrinsic concentration, that is Ni square. So this action is called a mass action law. Always any PN junction, this law must be satisfied. When this law violates, there is a voltage is generated. That voltage, either it may be a positive voltage or it may be a negative voltage. Based on the applications, we will see. So using this mass action law, we will explain the photovoltaic effect with respect to solar cell and anti-solar cell. Now, under thermal equilibrium, in the PN junction, where the emission, this arrow, red color arrow and this blue color arrow, that is the both are say both are equal, that is emission balances the absorption. No current is produced, no current is produced. So thereby the Fermi level is constant. There is no current is put, the PV junction is just ideal, that no action is happened. So that means the voltage is generated, that is delta mu is equal to zero. No voltage is generated in the PV panel, PV cell. No photovoltaic effect, nothing is happened. Now the next graph. When the PN junction is illuminated under the sun, this red color having more illumination, that is more incident, but the reflection is very less. See the diagram, there are incidence is high, but a reflection is less. So under illumination, there is a excess carrier is generated, excess holes and electrons are generated. That excess electrons N and the excess hole P, the product of NP is very much higher than the intrinsic constant Ni square. So due to that effect, when the concentration level is increased, The Fermi level of the PN junction is increased from the reference. See that this diagram, the dotted line mentioned that the Fermi level is increased by an amount based on the excess carrier generation. So this excess carrier generation will develop the voltage. That voltage we will call as photovoltaic voltage of particular cell. So this is this increment in the Fermi level we called as quasi Fermi level. Now this is about a solar cell. Now the solar cell is working which will generate always DC power. We need to connect a inverter to convert into AC. So this is a basic block diagram, as everyone know. But when we operate the solar panel under AC load, we must have the battery. Again, that is another thing. We must need inverter, and also to store the energy of the PV, to store the power and energy of the PV panel, we must have the battery. That is the biggest drawback in the solar panel. Now here because the drawbacks of the entire universe is using our entire universe is using solar panel only during the daytime. But when we want to when we want to operate at the night, we must have the battery. And furthermore, some more power electronic components are needed to integrate with the grid, so that that is not considered. So that involved, that is the biggest drawback in the PV solar PV panel. And of course, during the daytime also, it is working only 5 to 6 hours. 5 to 6 hours. In that period only, the sun, solar sun irradiance is very much high. So that is that was the drawback of a solar PV panel working in daytime. Now they introduced the concept called we need the solar cell which will work in the night also. People are thinking that. So, but some may think that it is a joke. But according to Jeremy Munde, who is the professor of University of California, he proposed the idea, his team proposed the idea called anti-solar panel from the knowledge developed by the Stanford researchers. They published the paper. The Stanford researchers have published the paper stating that thermoelectric generator which will radiate the heat, see the statement. They proposed the statement that thermoelectric generator which is radiates the heat to the sky can generate the electricity. So this is the idea given by the Stanford researchers. So that principle they named as anti-solar panel, which is opposite to the solar panel operation. So from that knowledge only, the professor Jeremy Munde have developed the idea. So according to the concept paper, which was published in 2020, that is this year, January month, it is a concept paper. In that concept paper, they proposed, Jeremy Munde and his research scholar, DP, proposed the concept that the anti-solar panel can generate the quarter of power what is generated by the solar panel in daytime. This is the idea they were proposed using some literature survey and some basic principles. They proposed the idea. That idea we will see now. Now, what is the primary difference between solar panel and anti-solar panel? Is that the primary solar panel, of course, we know everything. So solar panel, the heat source is the sun and the heat sink is the earth. There we place the solar panel. And the result we called as daytime photovoltaic. And the process we called as photovoltaic cell. Just opposite to this is called anti-solar panel, where we have this heat sink. Heat source is the earth, is the heat source. Earth is the heat source. You see this diagram, the next diagram. So the earth is the heat source, and the sky is the heat sink. It is called a nighttime photovoltaic. The process we named as a thermoradiative principle. Thermoradiative, we introduced the term thermoradiative cell. According to Professor Jeremy Munde, he made the statement that a regular solar cell generates the power by absorbing the sunlight, which causes the voltage to appear across the device and for current flow. But in this new device, this anti-solar panel, light is emitted and the current and voltage go in the opposite direction, but it still generates the positive power. So solar panel also generates positive power, and this also generates the positive power since voltage and current are in opposite direction. So generates the power is a positive. So this is a statement he made using the principle anti-solar and introduced a term called anti-solar panel. So this anti-solar panel is obviously placing towards the sky. Towards the sky, consider this sky is a cold one. The heat is radiated from the hot surface, that is hot solar panel, to the sky. That time the radiation is happened. Due to that radiation, so voltage is generated. That power is generated, that we will see. Now here, then the next one is anti-solar panel. It is obviously working under thermoradiative cell at its night. This is a panel. See the diagram. It is a panel. This which will emit the infrared rays to the sky, So that time there is some action, thermal equilibrium action. There is some equilibrium action happen inside the solar panel. Due to that, there is some voltage and the power is generated. That power we can use as a useful power. See, come to the Fermi level diagram. See this diagram. This is the solar panel. This solar panel, we have the radiation is very much higher than the incident. variation, that is radiation level, is higher than the incident level, this emission reduces the carrier concentration below the thermal equilibrium. But it is an opposite process in solar panel. In solar panel, there are more number of carrier concentration is generated, but here it reduces the carrier concentration below the thermal level, thermal equilibrium level. Thereby, the equilibrium line is going below the Fermi level is going below the line. Therefore, the product of hole concentration and electron concentration is less than the intrinsic concentration square. So that time we have the negative voltage is created. That negative voltage will create the negative current. Thereby, the positive power is generated. That positive power is converted into the useful power. Now, this is a comparison between photovoltaic and a thermoradiative cell. Now, here the first diagram, left side diagram, we have the thermo photovoltaic graph, where the Fermi level is increased above the reference level. There we generate the positive voltage and positive current, and we result the NP product in hole and electron product is higher than the Ni square, so which will generate the positive voltage. Thus, it is opposite to the in the processes happen in the opposite way in thermo radiative cell, where we have negative current. See the diagram. Next diagram. So the current is opposite to the previous. So previously the current is from left to right. Now it is right to left. So the current is flowing like this. Right. So voltage is generated in the opposite direction, and of course current also in the opposite direction. So here this is a statement made by him that the current flow in the opposite direction. The sign of voltage is also reversed. Therefore, both the scenario generate usable power. That is, both the solar panel and this anti-solar panel will generate the usable power. So from this diagram, see this diagram. This is the upper line, that is silicon solar cell. In the first quadrant, we have the photovoltaic effect. There we have current and voltage are positive, resulting positive power. This is the maximum power point. And the voltage are positive, resulting positive power. This is the maximum power point we mentioned in the back. See the back side, we have the maximum power point. And similarly, we have the third quadrant that we have called a thermoradiative process. Thermoradiative process where current and the anti-solar panel is also generate positive power, but the current and voltage is getting reversed. That is the idea proposed by the professor Jervis. Now let us explain using the diode characteristics, how the thermoradiative cell characteristics is achieved. As we stated previously, for the forward biased area, we have the diode characteristics. When we pull down the diode characteristics in the forward biased area, that is nothing but the photovoltaic cell characteristics. In the same manner, when we pull up the thermoradiative cell in towards up, that is nothing but a thermoradiative cell. That is how much it is pulled up, that is decided by the process happened in the for the solar cell. Now, when these two curves, as we stated, the power generated by the solar panel and anti-solar panel are positive. So let us come to the first quadrant, where voltage and current are positive, and of course power is positive. But the reason why we brought to study the behavior of both the solar panel and anti-solar panel. See the red color graph, that is original solar panel having the maximum power point. This is square having this edge having the maximum power point. This is square, red color we have the square, that is maximum power point. Again, this is a thermoradiative cell. When we flip into the again first quadrant, the shaded area having the maximum power, the edge of the corner of square having the maximum power point. So from observation we can note that the power generated by the thermoradiative cell, which is less than the power generated by the photovoltaic cell. But according to the professor, he told that that is only quarter of the what we generated in the daytime operation. So this is next idea, an item thermoradiative cell. It is a concept only, but it is not implemented, only concept only. Here we have the panel, solar panel, which will emit the infrared rays to the sky. This idea is called as hot surface, hot side, and the sky is a cold one. The energy is radiated from hot surface to the cold. When the energy is emitted from the hot to cold, there is a mismatch in the thermal equilibrium action. In that thermal equilibrium action, the voltage is generated. Right. So that is the idea. Next one is, so again, this is also a concept. This is a panel. And this panel is placed like this, like a vertical way. Right. Previously, we have the panel is placed in the vertical wave, and also we have the mirror, two mirrors, which is placed in a sliding manner. The sunlight which is falling to the mirror is heated up the one side of the panel. The mirror that reflects the sun's radiance towards the cell heats one side. So this side is, left side is getting heated. On the other side, the mirror which will transmit the solar radiance and reflect the thermal emission from the cell towards the deep space. So from that mirror, the energy is transmitted to the deep sky. So that time there is an energy, voltage is generated. It is a concept only, but it is not implemented. So in future, it may be implemented. Now they proposed one more metal called the metamaterials. That material having two properties. That property is the metamaterial can be engineered to direct solar irradiance passing through it towards one side of the device, while the thermal radiation from the cell back to the deep space. See the diagram. In the diagram, at one side, the irradiance level is fall into the hot surface. In the other side, we have the from the hot surface the radiance, that is energy, is flowing towards to the sky. So this is two actions happen. This is about the metamaterials. This is also in concept only. This is not implemented. So in future, it may be implemented. So this is a working proposed model by the professor. Here we have the thermoelectric generator. So that will generate the power. Through the power, we have the boost converter. From the boost converter, the LED is going. So this is the idea proposed. On the right side, we have the small arrangement. Using that arrangement, they made the experiment and they got successfully to grow the LED. And also they were involved in the process to replace the silicon material. Originally the solar panels are made with the silicon materials. Now the researchers are going in very deep to use the mercury instead of silicon or any other material to improve the efficiency, of course, an anti-solar panel. So the benefits of anti-solar panel is, the main benefits, which is the drawback of a solar panel. In the solar panel, we need a battery. Conventional solar panel operation in daytime, to store the energy, we need the battery. But here, we do not need the battery. In the 24, all the day, we generate the power. Throughout the day, we can generate the power. We can generate the power using this. It's caught in the crossfire. It's caught in the crossfire.